Welcome to Psychic Sid. This is for Ophicius. Ophicius are born from November 30th to December 18th. You don't have to be an Ophicius to resonate with this reading. You can end up connecting to somebody who has Ophicius in their astrological chart, or you can have Ophicius in your astrological chart somewhere. But you came across this reading and it just resonates for you. Right. Check your Chiron to see where you may resonate with this reading and where you may have Ophicius in your astrological chart. What's the future? Immediately, I heard something about a father. Something about a father. So either someone is a father, or this could be about your father. I see Pisces, Sagittarius, Ophicius, Aries energy, Scorpio energy as well. I also see Taurus, Aries, Scorpio, Taurus, and Leo. Okay? You have one. For some of you, this is also Capricorn energy. Then you have five. This could also be Aquarius energy. Number five. Many of you are turning to a priest, a bishop, or a shaman. But you coming to this reading, you are encountering a shaman. I am a professional shaman. Many of you are going to a priest, a bishop, or a shaman for insight, resolution, advice. You are sacrificing. There's something being sacrificed in order for you to come to a better sense of self-worth and self-value for yourself. Many of you are married. Many of you are actually married. Or you may own a spiritual business that's very well known. You could be a priest, a bishop, or a shaman. Some of you are like CEOs, head of your company. This could also be about a grandfather for some of you. Or someone who's at the head of a family. There's something being sacrificed, okay? Let's see what's going on. There is chaos and undoing. I'm hearing there's an undoing. Okay, so something's being undone. I heard that really strong father. Father. Or grandfather. This could have been a death. Some of you, there was a death. Some sort, or there has been, or there will be. Could have been your baby. Could have been a child for some of you. Something that made you feel like it was rock bottom for you. In order for you to receive a brand new opportunity. The Ace of Pentacles. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. It can also be Aquarius. Maybe this is a new job, some type of financial abundance coming your way. For many of you, even an award. Seven of Wands, Leo, and Mars. Standing up for yourself. You can be a motivational speaker, a public speaker. You could also be blocking someone. And High Priestess, Moon in Virgo. She had to make an appearance, huh? Hidden energy of the Five of Pentacles in reverse, Taurus and Mercury can. Oh, that's beautiful. Taurus and Mercury. Another five. Okay. So, if you're in a relationship, you are catered to as the feminine energy. If you're single, you're a woman many people believe they just cannot have. Okay? Or you're encountering a woman that makes you feel like she's just a woman that like no one can have. She's just out of this world. Right? This is someone who's very interested in the mysteries of the universe. Does not have any sense of sexual intercourse until they're actually in an official relationship. Also blooming later in something than what was intended. So this could be in your career for many of you, finally getting the recognition that you deserve, or finally being seen for the talent that you have. You don't speak unless you absolutely need to. The High Priestess is usually a tarot card reader, a psychic. This can also represent someone who is very quiet or only speaks when it's absolutely necessary. You could also play sports for some of you. Some of you guys are into music. You could be a musician, so that could be rapper, singer, okay? Some of you work with nature or healing. You could be some kind of healer. So maybe you're a doctor, a nurse for some of you guys. Some of you work in prisons, institutions, or asylums, philosophy, psychology, or you can work in spirituality. Okay? You have an inner knowing. You could also be consulting a psychic or a tarot card reader of some sort. If you're in a relationship, you will feel valued in this relationship. You will feel like the person you're with values you, like you don't want anything outside of that relationship. But it's also because you're gonna have a very good sense of self-worth and self-value. The High Priestess is above the Empress. That's because she understands emotional intelligence. She's not gonna overextend herself and over-nurture something or someone. She nurtures herself. If you don't have a job, I see you getting a job. If you're single, I see you having a really good sense of self-worth and self-value for yourself. If you're married, they're not going to remarry after you pass away. I see Gemini energy. Someone's not going to remarry after you. After you, they're done. Also, there's someone looking over your love life. Someone deceased. Someone is looking over your love life. Doesn't matter who you're supposed to be with, that person is also being looked over by whoever is deceased. Okay? Cool. Now, I think you also own a business with your significant other. Okay? Yeah. Yep. That's the truth. And they're very faithful to you. Doesn't matter if you're a man or a woman. They're faithful to you through and through, and they're also a really good father. Someone's a dad. Grandfather or something. For some of you, I just got chilled on my body. For some of you, it's someone deceased. It could be a grandfather or father. But for many of you, if you're in a relationship, they're faithful to you through and through. Through and through. You have many memories with them. Maybe even children. Yeah. They could be the CEO. Or if you're single, you're meeting someone online. Aries, Scorpio, like, you're meeting someone who's in another state or country. There's someone who could be very far away from you for some of you. This could be long distance. Many of you are also moving in with your significant other, being proposed to, or you're pregnant. Congratulations. The baby's coming soon. Yeah. This is about career. I see you being recognized. You could be a rapper, dancer, actor, singer. Doesn't matter the gender. This is a beautiful reading. Oh, beautiful. Love it. Love to see it. The High Priestess is a very gorgeous energy. It's the Moon of Virgo energy, and it's usually, you know, it's a very feminine energy. Okay, of course, men can also have the Moon in Virgo. But the High Priestess is usually a woman. Okay? It could be someone you're meeting that has that type of energy. Examples of the Moon and Virgo woman are Nicki Minaj, Serena Williams, Lizzo, Blake Lively, Jada Pinkett Smith, myself. I'm a Moon and Virgo woman. Aaliyah was a Moon and Virgo woman. The energy of the Moon and Virgo woman is very unique. It's very different. Once they're committed in an actual relationship, that's it for them. Like, once they actually get, like, married and commit, that's it for them. Typically, they can go through fire in that relationship, and the relationship will withstand. Because it's a High Priestess energy. It's someone who's even better than the Empress. Yeah. It's a very fascinating energy to work with. They're usually very talented at different things, or they have unique ability depending on what's in their chart. You have the medium. The palm reader tells you that your wish will soon come true. The wait is over, and you are about to receive what you have wished for. Be ready to catch it. Your affirmation is, I easily manifest everything I want into my life. All is well. Repeat this affirmation 3 times. 3 times a day for 3 days. Okay. Congrats, OPP. I love you so much. Congrats. Maybe you've also established really good boundaries, or you blocked out anyone that had negative intentions towards you. And I see money just flowing in. Doesn't matter what gender. Doesn't matter. Lots of shmoney. Okay? Congratulations! In a new job. If this is a relationship, it is very like, you're very public with the relationship. It's Jupiter and Leo. Here it can be Pisces or Pisces. You also keep seeing 11-11. If you're single, people just love to say that they know you. Like, they love to be associated with you or know you. You're being recognized for what you do and career and just for who you are, what you believe in that brings you joy. Congratulations, officials! Congrats on your wish coming true. We're gonna get one card for your overall energy. Number two. You may have been seeing a lot of twos. There's a sense of fulfillment coming into your life. And you can feel it coming. This is actually duality. This is also partnership for many of you. This is also the recognition of what your experience has actually brought you throughout your life. The way you communicate is different, and how you feel is different, Ophicius. You feel the love internally, but you're also excited to learn more, to connect more, even to yourself. It's quite beautiful. There's like a willingness to understand that, you know, water is emotion, being open to receiving. So this is about emotional vulnerability, being more aware of how you feel and aware of how others may feel. This is beautiful. This has been your reading, Ophicius. Ashay.